Jesnel Church. I would just want to apologize for what I'm wearing. I was not expecting na ako po yung speaker niyo ngayon. It was a surprise by Sir Basamba. No, God is good. All the time? You know, I just want to share muna a testimony so that we can get to know each other before I share the message. It's not long. Throughout this semester, I had a tough time. Metik po ako sa UB. And I wanted to do something for God after the semester. Kasi wala na klase. So I said, Lord, I don't want to be idle. Meron po ako comprehensive exam, but I want to serve you. And so I said, Lord, I want every Sabbath that you send me somewhere to serve. Kahit hindi ako speaker, it's fine. And so, I saw Sir Win yesterday. I went to Puting Kahoy Church. And he gave me a ride back home. And I told him, tomorrow, I want to be with you. And he said, yeah, I'm speaking somewhere. And he was here. So I came here na expecting ako yung makinig, ni magsalita. And I want to apologize, mahirap po yung Tagalog ko because I grew up sa England, bata po ako. At saka Bisaya, hindi ako Tagalog speaking. But I know how to I can understand Bisaya, but I cannot speak it. Kasabot bilang kabalo magstorya, gamayra. But I struggle with Tagalog. So I hope na you can understand po if I cannot. But I believe that the Holy Spirit will speak to us today. Amen?
Amen.
You know, when I grew up, when I was 18 years old, it was my most loneliest birthday. I was away from home, studying in college back in England. And I asked God, Lord, what's the purpose of my life? Have you ever felt lonely in your life and you don't know what's your purpose? And it was in my 18th birthday, I said to God, Lord, use me. No matter what. And I pray to God, Lord, I will never say no to you. From that day onward, whenever there was an opportunity to sing, even though I'm not a singer, I would sing. An opportunity to preach, even though I don't consider myself a preacher, I would preach. And from that day on, God used me in England. And I became the North lay evangelist for the North England Conference. I never knew what God can do in my life until I said, Lord, I will never say no. So my challenge to you before I share the message, maybe there's a young person here. They don't know their purpose in life. Parang, ano ba, bakit ako dito sa mundo? And ask God, Lord, use me however you want to use me. And you will be surprised how God will use you. See, I'm so blessed to share the word of God. I never thought I'd make it to Palawan, to Romblon, to Bagudbol, to Baguio. Many places I've been, Zamboanga, to share the word of God. And I met so many young people. I never imagined in my life I could have been doing the old stuff. Partying, going to clubs. But that would be a boring life. And so I just want to share it to someone very young. God wants you while you're young. And we'll never get too old to serve Him. And so my encouragement, now, never say no to God. When you say yes, yes Lord, you will be surprised how God will use you and transform your life. And take you to many places you never thought you would go. And meet people you will never thought you would meet. God is amazing if we give Him control in our lives. So I want to begin this word, the word with a word of prayer. And invite the Holy Spirit. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we want to ask for your Holy Spirit. You are the message. I'm just a mouthpiece. And so Lord, I just ask that you humble me. Do not let me speak, Lord. Choose your words. And Lord, select them.
that whatever I say will only be in accordance to your will. Father, there is a language barrier. May your Holy Spirit translate the message so everybody here can be blessed. We believe that, Lord, in the last days, people will speak in tongues. I may not know how, but only you can make understanding. For spiritual things are spiritually understood. And so, Father, we ask for your Holy Spirit to teach us now. We reverently come, and we want to hear from you in Jesus' name. Amen.
I want to invite you, Paul, to open your Bibles to 1 Peter chapter 1. Chapter 5, verse 8. Ano po sinabi ko? 1 Peter? Chapter 5, verse 8. Sorry. 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 8.
This is what it says.
If you're there, please say amen.
1 Peter 5, verse 8.
Are you there? Nandiyan na po kayo?
Okay. Let's read. The Bible says, be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, walks about like a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour.
The Bible is teaching us a lesson this morning, that we have to be sober and be vigilant. Sober, what does it mean to be sober? Meaning you're not drunk. And be vigilant. What does that mean? Lagi kang conscious about your surroundings. You're very careful. You want to know what's in front of you, what's on your side, and who's behind. In a Christian life, we live in a world that is not just the physical world, but also the spiritual. And the Bible is telling us today that we have to be sober and be vigilant because we have Satan described as a lion. You see, I like the Bible. The Bible describes spiritual things in the physical. Kasi mahirap po maintindihan yung spiritual things. So if we know what Satan is like, then we know how to be able to resist him. And the Bible described Satan as a lion. Anybody here seen a lion? Nakita na po kayo ng lion?
Anybody here been to Manila Zoo? I haven't been inside, pero before we were very pobre. I've never been in a zoo.
So when we went to Manila Zoo, kasi yung auntie ko naglibre ng my sister and my brother, they went ahead. And dad said, nakakahiya naman kung tatlo kayo, mahal yung ano, yung entrance fee. So nandun ako sa labas. But what's amazing thing about Manila Zoo is that in the entrance is the lion encounter. So even though I didn't go inside sa zoo, at least nakakita ko ng lion. And when I saw the lion, it was really big. It's bigger than me. Now, I like watching animal shows, but I never saw a man fight a lion. Unless they have a gun or they are a Maasai warrior. In Africa, there's a country called Kenya. And there's a tribe of people called the Maasai tribe. It is the culture that before a boy turns into a man, he first has to be circumcised. And before he can be fully a man, kailangan niya magpatay ng lion. Before he can get married, he has to kill a what? A lion. So they are circumcised at a certain age, and then they will be going out there, and they have to kill a lion. Now, in their culture, they're Africans. The girls will be very impressed if you killed a lion. And so the reservation of Kenya made a deal with them. Please don't kill that much lion because they're endangered species. But I was amazed that there are people in this world who are not afraid to fight and kill a lion. And you know what they have? They only have a bow and a spear.
But the only reason why they fight a lion is because they have a weapon. Without a weapon, only a drunk person would be stupid enough to fight a lion. The Bible says, watch. What's watch in Tagalog? Tumingin. And be sober. Our adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, seeking, walking about, seeking whom he may devour. Now, what's the difference between a lion and the devil? You see, the lion, we can see. The devil, we cannot. So the Bible is asking us to do something. Watch and be sober, because your enemy, the devil, like a lion, walking about, seeking whom he may devour. No, can you see the devil? Makita mo ba ang diablo? No, but the Bible is telling us, watch and be sober. What's the problem here? Can we see the devil? Maybe if he's possessing someone. And so many of us face temptation, assuming that by our own strength and power, we can overcome. At times, we are like that drunk person without self-awareness and consciousness of our vulnerability. One thing about a lion that I've learned, this is a simple message. The reason why it can catch buffaloes is because the buffalo cannot see. If you imagine a lion, kung makita mo yung lion, its color is the same as the
grass.
It's brown or orange, and the grass is also what? Brown, and it's camouflage. And if you don't have that watchfulness, that soberness, you cannot distinguish the devil from what is good or evil. We cannot, by our own strength, overcome the temptation from within and without. The strength comes from God. This is why we need to learn to submit to God first before we try resisting the devil. Then he will flee from us. In James 4, verse 7, I want to take you there. James 4, verse 7, this is what it says. Therefore, submit to God, resist the devil, and he will what? Flee from you. So there's the devil who is around us. We cannot see him. And if we only pray, remember what Jesus said to Peter, Peter, watch and pray. For the spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. Did Peter pray? Did he watch? No. And so what happened to him? Next thing, he was denying God. And Peter said, no, I will never deny God. Many of us in our Christian life, we think now, we will never do this. We will never go there. But because we're not watching, we're not praying, we end up doing the things we never thought we would ever do. Or go to places we never thought we would ever go. Why? Because akala natin, we have the strength. But can you fight a lion, a physical lion? No. It will overpower you. Can you fight a spiritual lion? What is your weapon against a spiritual lion? Praying and what? Watchfulness. If you don't pray, if you don't watch, if you're not careful what's in front of you, what am I listening? What am I hearing? What am I talking about? Am I in the right place? Am I with the right people? You, if you are not conscious about these things, you're just, you know, I'll go wherever I go. I'll listen to whatever I listen. I'll eat what I want to listen. I'll watch what I want to watch. What will happen to you is you will end up becoming a prey of the devil. You see, when you're blind, spiritually blind, you begin to see things that is not good for you as something that is good. You become unable to distinguish what's good from evil. And when temptation comes at your face and it appears, and genuine temptation,
You don't have the strength to say no. Anybody here experienced that you went through a temptation and you gave in? You try resisting, but you cannot? You see, the devil will never tempt us with things that you don't like. Or else, hindi yan temptation. And the Bible is telling us that you cannot, if you're not watching, if you're not sober, you cannot resist. And so, how are we to resist the enemy? The Bible says you have to submit to God. Before you resist the temptation, the enemy, kailangan natin mag-submit to God. Then, resist him and the devil will flee from you. Verse 8 says, draw near to God and he will draw near to us. Now, I have a question. Are you close to God? Malapit po kayo sa Panginoon. Because your ability to resist temptation depends on your closeness with God. It's not your willpower. Akala nyo, if I just resist, I will never. That's what Peter thought. Akala niya, he can say no to sin. Why? Because he's been with Jesus 3 years. Akala natin, I've been in the church, I've been an Adventist, I can say no. It doesn't come from you. The strength doesn't come from you. If you cannot fight and overcome a real lion, what makes you think that you can fight and overcome a spiritual lion? The Bible says we have to draw near to God and he will draw near to you. And when the devil sees na malapit tayo sa Panginoon, he will what? Flee from us. One thing I realize is that lions do not run away from their prey. They only run away or flee from bigger lions. What did I say? Lions do not run away from their prey. Yung kinakain nila. They only run away. They don't run away from elephants. Sometimes they run away, yeah, but they're not afraid. They only run away from bigger lions. God is bigger than the devil. He is stronger and will dominate the enemy at every encounter. I don't think you're appreciating what I said. God is bigger. Mas malaki ang Panginoon than the devil. He is stronger and will dominate the enemy every encounter. So that tells me that every time I fall in sin, it is because I am not with God. And there is no reason that the enemy should run away from me if God is not with me by my side. We struggle with sin. Lagi tayong natitempt and we fall. We say no, but we say yes. And our life is filled with defeat. Why? One thing, because you're doing it by yourself. You're doing it alone. You can never, no matter how much you know here, be able to say no to sin. Because the devil knows you can't handle it. He knows you want it. And it comes to us in many ways, and we cannot see it. Sometimes the devil uses those you love to irritate you. And you think that the problem is them, when really it's the enemy. But you cannot see it. Satan doesn't run away from you. He only runs away from God. My question is God with us? Do we draw
and seek our safety from Him. Thus, He will not attack us so long as He knows He will not encounter Jesus in our lives. He is like the lion. He's going here and He's looking for a time in your life you are not with Jesus. He's looking for those opportunities that you woke up in the morning, you didn't open your Bible, you didn't pray, that tells Him you're not with Jesus. He's looking for a time when you are with someone you're not supposed to be with. That's when He attacks. He looks for the time when you've not been praying, you skip church, you watch a movie that takes away the Holy Spirit from your life. You're not watching, you're not careful, you're not sober. He attacks you when you are at your weakest. He looks for a time in your life, Jesus is not there. Jesus is everywhere, but He will not force Himself upon you. In fact, the Bible says, "Behold, I stand at the door and knock." Jesus is very polite. When He comes to your house, He goes, "Tao po." He doesn't go inside and comes into your life. And sometimes when the devil sees that Jesus is saying "Tao po, Tao po, Tao po" every day, but He's not inside your life, He will go inside. But whenever God is in our life, we make Him priority. He's with us. We're praying. We're reading a Bible. We are breathing His presence. The devil will not enter. We need to learn to run to God in times of our weakness. The enemy cannot overpower us so long as we submit to God. He knows our safety is to be constantly in His presence through prayer and meditation of His word. This is why the devil wants you to be so busy, you don't have time to read your Bible. The devil wants you to be so busy, you don't have time to pray. Anybody here had experience? Or you pray, or you read the Bible, but you're not doing it. You're not focused. You're distracted. This is what the enemy does. He is not really wanting to tempt you straight away. He will never tempt you if you're reading your Bible. He will tempt you after He managed to make you not spend time with God. When we linger far from God or fight in our own strength, the enemy knows we will surely be devoured. Sometimes we don't know because we're not sober. We are not vigilant. Sometimes we don't know that God is not with us. Anong sinabi ko? Minsan, hindi natin alam that our Diyos malayo sa atin. We don't know. And it's a very dangerous thing to be someone who doesn't even know that they are not with God. The enemy waits for this opportunity. And he watches and anticipates for the opportunity when we drift from his presence and become overly confident or self-reliant. Then he pounces on us. Whenever you feel that, "I'm okay, why should I read my Bible? I read it 5 minutes today. Why should I pray all the time? I mean, I don't eat pork, I don't do this." Whenever you think you are confident, you feel complacent, that's when he attacks. Can we afford to be complacent, compromising, and careless with our spirituality? The battle is real, and those who will overcome
are only those who acknowledge their weakness and vulnerability. You see, you will never go to God if you don't realize how weak you are. You will never pray and seek His presence in your life and read His Word if you don't realize you are not safe with Him. So long as you think you can do it by yourself, you will not submit yourself to God. In fact, the Bible says, God resists the proud but gives grace to the humble. How many times do you have to fall and fall and fall until you realize, Lord, I can't do it by my own strength? There are two kinds of lions. Coming to a close. One that devours and one that protects. What did I say? There's two classes of lions. One that what? Devours. And one that protects. You see, a lion, a male lion, you know, lalaki, mahabang buhok, their job is to protect the young cubs, mga baby na lions, and to protect their surroundings. So a lion, a male lion, while the females are hunting, every day, this is what he does. He makes this deep growl. Every morning, and this can be heard for many miles. And you know why the lion always does this morning, sun, midday, and late evening? To tell the other lions, I am around. So when they hear a lion in the morning, go, very deep voice, and roars every morning. Other lions in the area, even though they don't see where the lion is, will know that there are lions in this place, and this is my area. In fact, the lion would spend, when he's awake, you know, and he would wee here, they will go, there, everywhere. I wonder how many water they have to drink so they can keep weeing. This marks the territory that, hey, this is my territory. And whenever another lion comes in that area, they can smell that there's a lion here. That lion is protecting his territory. And no lion would enter in that place unless they are willing to fight. Because a male lion would die to protect his own pride. My friends, and there's also a lion seeking to devour. This lion is looking for opportunities to hunt and to kill. Every time we pray, I want to tell you that there's a lion who stands by our side. Every time we read His Word and we meditate upon Him, there is a lion who goes around us. Every time we read our Bible, a lion patrols our surrounding. But every time we neglect meditating on His Word, another lion is waiting to ambush us from our environment. And whenever we neglect both prayer and meditation, we fail to spot the enemy lurking around us, camouflaged in front of our eyes. Have you ever fallen with your eyes wide open? The only lion that protects, that stands by our side when we pray, that patrols our surrounding when we meditate His Word, is the Lion of Judah. He can smell, he can see the Lion of adversary. This lion that the other lion runs away from is the lion of the tribe of Judah. Jesus is that bigger lion. The other lion fears and flee from him. The battle is real. We are either part of a pride or one of the enemy's prey. We determine that by deciding whether we will flee, we will submit or not submit to him. My message is done. My question is, have you submitted your life to God? Malapit po kayo sa Diyos. If God is not in your life, if you don't draw near to him, he will not draw near to you. You have to invite Christ in your life if you are going to live a successful Christian life. And so I want to read that text. James 4, verse 7. Therefore, submit to God. Then you can resist the devil and he will flee from you. He's not really fleeing from you. He's fleeing, running away from the one that is with you. Draw near to God and he will draw near to you. Do you want victory in your life? Anybody here struggling with sinful tendencies, sinful character habits, any weakness you have that the devil uses against you? If you want victory in your life, the answer is you have to draw nearer to God. Every time the devil sees you are with God, he flees. You know the reason why Enoch walked with God and he was translated to heaven? You know why he lived a very successful life? Was because the enemy could not touch him so long as he was walking with God. Who wants to live that life? I want to walk with God. I want to live a life victorious. I'm sick of getting my temper overcoming me. I'm sick of not being able to resist temptation. I'm sick of reacting in a very un-Christ-like way. I'm sick of having defeats in my life. If you want to make a commitment today, Lord, I want to draw near to you. You are the lion that protects. You are the bigger, the stronger, the lion that dominates, whom the enemy flees from. If you want to draw near to him today and you want to make a commitment, Lord, I want to read my Bible. I want to pray. I want to invite you in my life. I want you to patrol me. I want you to protect me. I want you to be ahead, behind, and side to side. I want you in my life. I want Satan, whenever he comes close to me, he can smell Jesus and runs away. Whenever he comes close to me and tempts me, he can hear the roar of Jesus and it scares him away. I want to go wherever God wants me to go so that when the enemy comes, he runs away because he knows I'm not alone. Is this your experience? You want to experience this in your life? If this is you, I want you to stand and we're going to bow our heads for a word of prayer. I want Christ, the Lion of Judah, in my life. I want the enemy to smell him and so he runs away. I want him to hear him so that when he comes and even tries to tempt me, there is a lion bigger than him who he is afraid. I want to live a life. I want to be more than conquerors. You're standing. You want to make a commitment. Lord, I don't want to be far from you. I am not safe. It's not what you know, how many things you know that keeps you from living a sinless life is who you are with. You're standing because you want to make a commitment. Lord, I'm not safe. I've fallen many times. I made promises I did not keep. And today I realize I am not safe. I can't even see the devil. Because I can't see him, but he can see you. I want you to be with me. I want to make that commitment to read my Bible. Pray. Invite him in my life. Not just on the Sabbath day, but every day. Should we bow our heads for a word of prayer? Heavenly Father, we thank you that you are that bigger I am. You desire, Father, to save us. Desire to give us victory in our lives. And Father, every time we fall, it was because, Father, we wandered far from you. And perhaps today someone is standing and they realize, Lord, I am not as close to you as I should. I did not draw near to you. That's why you feel so far. But I thank you, Father, that you desire to be by our side. You desire to protect us. You desire to give us victory in our lives and protection. Father, we are not safe. In fact, the Bible, Ellen White says, we are not safe a day or an hour without prayer. And some of us, Lord, we come to church, but we don't pray. We come to church to hear your word, but we don't open our Bibles every day. We think we're okay. We think we don't need to do that. And yet, when you look at our lives, we are often defeated. Father, Lord, we need you. How much? Sometimes the devil knows more than we know ourselves. And so, Lord, we stand. Because we want to rededicate our lives again. And commit ourselves to seeking you. And Lord, not only does the enemy feel your presence, smell your presence, hear your voice, we too can also feel your presence. Breathe your atmosphere and hear your voice speaking to us. Father, you're coming soon. And it's the enemy's goal that none of us be saved, but we be devoured by sin. Lord, we come to you because only you can give us victory. And Father, we want to be able to stand, resist the enemy, and he flees. And so, Lord, please come into your in our lives as we invite you in. We want to walk with you as Enoch walked with God. And Lord, it is impossible for us to sin so long as we come. We come. Keep coming. Keep praying. Keep seeking you. Keep meditating upon your word in our lives. Thank you, Father, that in you there is victory. We thank you that you want to stand by our side. You are the lion of the tribe of Judah, the bigger, the stronger one. And that you can give us victory until Jesus comes. We thank you, Lord, that you are our source of strength. In Jesus' name, amen.